गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल। आज हम देखेंगे चैप्टर नंबर 4, सब्जेक्ट साइंस, सॉर्टिंग मटेरियल इनटू ग्रुप्स। इसका हम एक्सपेरिमेंट करेंगे आज। जो भी इनसॉल्युबल सॉल्युबल सब्सटेंस है वो हमें पता चलेगा। तो लेट अस डू इट। विच आर द सॉल्युबल सब्सटेंस एंड विच आर इनसॉल्युबल सब्सटेंस। बिफोर दैट वी विल सी दैट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मटीरियल्स विच वी यूज विच वी टूक एज अ एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ प्लेट। So let us look that of example of a plate. Now here you can see that it is an example of a plate where they have given a property of appearance and hardness can be criteria for grouping. So this is a plate in which they have given the wooden plate. You can see the wooden plate. The second number is of a plastic plate where the material is of a plastic. This is of a steel plate which is made up of stainless steel, which is used in your homes. Glass plate which is also used in your home, and paper plates which are used normally in the parties and marriage functions or anywhere, and a ceramic plate which is made up of a mud or a ceramic, which we can say as a ceramic plate. Now this is a material by which we took one example of this is a example of plate. Now like that we are also doing doing the experiment of a soluble and insoluble substance. So let us start soluble and insoluble substance. So you can see in this image that they have took sugar and oil. Like that we are going to do example. Now for insoluble and soluble substance, today we are going to do a taste of salt and sugar. Here we have took a salt and sugar sample by taking a water in this test tube. Put a half water filled with a water. As you can see here, I am filling the water in the test tube. As you can see here, we can see that I have put some water in this test tube, and now I am adding salt in this test tube. As you can see that I am adding salt in this test tube. Now let us stir. By stirring it, you can see that the salt is dissolving in the water. Now you can see that the salt has been dissolved in the water. You can see salt has been in dissolved form. So by this we can say that the salt is in a soluble form. Now again I have took a water in this test tube, and let us add now the another sample, which is I have here took of a sugar. Now add some sugar in this water, then what it becomes, what we see the result, that we will see in this test tube. Here I am adding the sugar in this test tube by which we can see. Now let us stir the test tube. What happens we will see by this. By dissolving, it is dissolved in water or insoluble in water, we can see that the sugar is melting in the water. Now let us look by stirring it. After few minutes you can see that the sugar has been dissolved in the water because it is melted, and it is due to its solidness it gets few minutes to dissolve in the water. So here you can see that the sugar has been dissolved in the water. No particles has been left in this test tube. So now like that we have to do the insoluble form of a here we are taking the oil as an example. So now let us test the oil in the water. Now as you can see that I have took test tube number 3 where I have took half of the water filled in this test tube, and now take some oil or any kerosene or any substance which is insoluble in water. So here I am taking the sample of an oil by which we can see that oil is soluble or insoluble in this in the water. So now let us do the test. Here I have put some oil in this test tube, and as you can see that it has made a layer of separate layer in this water. So what you can say that here, here we can say that the oil is insoluble in water. By mixing it, let us see what happens to the oil. So by stirring it, you can see it becomes a droplet in the water. You can see, as you can see here, it becomes a droplet, and again it becomes a layer. By that droplet, the water is separated and the oil is also separated. So here we can say that the oil and water is insoluble to the oil. Okay. This is the test for solubles and insoluble in water. Now let us look forward. A floating material, and as I have said the floating object float or shrink. So which are the object which float or shrink? The leaf is the object where you can see that it is floating material. And the shrinking material is a stone where you can see that it goes under the water, and as you can see in this picture. So number 5, that is transparency, the opaque, translucent and transparent. As you can see in this this picture, opaque, they never see any object passes through the image. We cannot see anything. In translucent, we can see lighter the object, and in transparent we can see face to face, the object is clear and image. So thank you, this was the experiments, and this was the experiment, and by which we can see the different materials used in which, like for example dish. As we have seen the example of dish, where plastic, ceramic and metal and many types of dishes were seen. Thank you.